I feel so good when you take your lashes off.
So this look started out inspired by a Harlequin doll that I have hanging in my room. But apparently I had Harley Quinn on the brain because I ended up with a lot of black and red. Okay, well I ended up with only black and red. But that's besides the point. Let's go ahead and jump right into it. It's pretty simple. We're going to start out with priming your eyelids with any kind of primer that you desire. I happen to be using Urban Decay Primer Potion at the moment. And then I'm taking my NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk that is going to go all over just my eyelid. And then I'm taking Sugarpill's Love Plus, and this is going to go on the outer two-thirds of my eye. I'm just packing that in because it's going to be a nice base. I'm going right underneath my eye as well. And then I'm going to take a fluffy brush and just smoke it out a little bit, make it nice and fluffy. Grabbing Asylum from Sugarpill, I am placing this over where we placed Love Plus. And then taking again that fluffy blending brush, and we're gonna smoke it out, being sure to bring it down under the eye further than you normally would. Using any black color, I'm using the one in the Kat Von D Shade and Light Eye Palette, and a tiny brush, I'm just filling in the inner corner, blending that into the red, and then I'm taking a fluffy brush and the white that's in the same palette and smoking out the edges. Using my NYX Collection Noir eyeliner, I am just making a simple wing. Nothing much to this, so we're just gonna kinda speed up this process a little bit. And using any black pencil, just fill in your waterline. Switching back to the black liner, I am using this to create the teardrop and also the small black dots. And then I'm actually taking a red Vivid Brights. Wait a minute, what is that twitch? What is that? Anywho, do a large dot underneath the tear and then tiny red dots mixed in with the black. Think freckles. That's the best way to describe this.
Cue short dance break.
Alright guys, we've had our fun. It's time to get serious. Just kidding, we're gonna speed this process up because it is exactly the same as the other side. Except, well, we're just switching out the colors. Black for red, red for black, etc., etc. Oh, and that little thing that I was using, that little blendy thing, that's gonna be your best friend ever. Yeah, that thing right there. If you don't know what it is, it cleans your brushes without the use of water. It's just a little spirally, spongy donut thingy. I don't know how to describe it, but they are pretty darn awesome, so you should go check them out. They sell them at Sephora and I am sure other places as well. But anyways, back to the look. I am smoking out that black, and then I'm going to be taking that white and fluffing the edges, lining the waterline, and I'm using that red to create a wing because it's pretty. Also creating the tear with no twitches this time, and some red dots, a black dot, some more black dots. Time to move on to the eyebrows now. I'm taking a spoolie and just combing through my brows, and then on the red eye, I am taking black and filling in my brows. It's pretty standard, just, you know, fill them in however you normally would. Comb that through. And then moving on to the black eye, I am taking the NYX pencil, whiting out my eyebrows, and then combing it through. If you happen to have light eyebrows or no eyebrows, then skip that NYX step and just go right on in with the red. Again, just like you normally would, fill in those brows. I'm just using a light bit of blush. This is Morticia and Gomez from Kat Von D, and putting that lightly onto my cheeks. For lip look number one, the red and black ombre, I am lining half of my mouth with a red lip liner. Anything will work, just so that you have an idea of space. Then on the other side, I'm going in with black. This one is from Colourpop. They make a really, really good black lip liner. So for the red side, I am taking Sanguis from Blackmoon Cosmetics, and on the black, I'm using Weirdo from Jeffree Star. I'm starting out by placing them on the lips kind of where I want, and then going back in with a lip brush and smudging them together. I wanted to get a really, really nice ombre shape. You just have to play with it, work with it, and eventually you'll get it. And you'll probably have to do some damage control with Q-tip. And voila! And then I didn't show on camera, but I did throw on some spiky lashes specifically for this look. For look number two, it is quite a bit easier and a little less dramatic. I am taking Nude Beige Lip Liner from NYX. This is just a literally beige color. And then going back over with Sheer Walk of Shame from Urban Decay, this just gives a really nice nude lip. And there you go, both lip looks are completely done. Do with it what you will. Alright guys, so that is everything. Now, I have tried to film this, I'm not kidding you, four times, and something has always gone wrong. I didn't have time, my battery ran out, my card got full, it was just insane. So I'm finally filming this, and damn it, it better be good when I put it on the computer, otherwise I'm gonna cry. Anyways, if you guys really enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that you can keep having more fun with me. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, etc. Whoa, I just like totally went out of focus. Come back. The sun changed, I'm sorry. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, feel free to leave those in the comments below and I will get back to you. And you can always find me on Instagram and Twitter at Jen Pereira, just like it's spelled here, to make it super simple. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye, lovelies.